Hello and welcome to another video on Evony. We continue discussing buffs. In the previous video, we covered the basics of when buffs apply and where to get them. Now let's go deeper into the different types of buffs. Increasing buffs isn't easy, especially if you're not spending a lot of money in the game. There are many ways to get them, but each requires something that you probably don't have a huge number of. Tactic scrolls, gold, rune stones, blood of Ares, blood crystals, etc., etc. So we end up having to make choices and to prioritize some buffs over others. A clear example is choosing a lead general. And sometimes the choices are not very clear or easy to make. We have different types of buffs. There are four different types of troops, different attributes, in percentages or flat buffs. So if you consider the main three attributes, attack, defense, and HP, we have 24 different combinations, and they take different ranges of values. So which ones are more important? For example, is a 10% mounted HP buff better or a 1000 flat ground defense? Well, there are some rules of thumb that I will cover a bit later, but the more accurate answers may eventually depend on what troops the buffs are applied to and in one situation. So I made a tool to compare different buffs and to better understand what they effectively mean for a certain keep or march. Let's start with the basics, and then I'm going to use the tool for a certain choice I need to make right now about my ground equipment. So the first thing to note is that buffs are applied to the base troop stats. So let's take a T12 archer as an example. It has a base attack of 3000. Then if I have a 2000% attack buff and 700 flat attack buff in a battle, the final effective attack value for that one archer is 63,700. But the enemy has some debuffs as well. Where does that go? That reduces the percentage buff that I have. So if the enemy has 800% archer attack debuff, the final attack stat goes down to 39,700. And note that this debuff cannot go higher than half of the percentage buff. And more importantly, it has no effect on your flat buffs. So the value added by these two types of buffs largely depends on the base stat. If this base stat is higher, you get more units of the stat from one percentage buff. At the same time, the higher the base stat is, the less value one unit of flat buff is adding. So let's first take a look at different troop stats. You can see here that grounds have high HP and also high defense. So their durability is high. It means they can take a lot of damage before getting killed, but their attack is not so great. Then we have cavs that also have high HP. Their attack is higher than their defense. The stats for archers and siege may look low, but they have the advantage of distance. Their high range allows them to deal damage to enemy troops without getting any counter damage. To make it clear, let's visualize a simplified version of one PvP encounter. Let's say one layer of grounds is attacking one layer of ground troops. Each side attacks the other, deals some damage, and kills some troops. So this side does that and the other side as well. This happens in multiple rounds until all troops on one side die. So this is one layer, then the full battle looks something like this. Ground and cavalry are in front lines. They are the vanguard. And then you have your rear guard, archers and siege in the back. Optimally, what you want is a vanguard that can block the enemy as long as possible while your rear guard attacks them. So you want high durability for your vanguard and high attack for the rear guard. So what does that mean in terms of buffs? Let's go back to this simple representation. Thanks to Derek DeFries for digging these formulas out, we know how these numbers are calculated. Now let's take the perspective of the attacker on the left. If you increase your attack, you deal more damage and kill more troops per round of battle. But instead, if you increase your defense, you reduce the damage that your troops receive in each round, which will then reduce your dead troops. And finally, if you increase your HP, your troops are basically harder to kill, so the dead troops are reduced. But is HP more important or defense? Let's look at a single round of battle between 1 million troops on each side, and look at the impact of 100% buffs of different types. As you can see, attack increases the damage that you deal to the enemy, and also the number of troops that you kill. But the other two buffs have no effect. Then defense is the only one that reduces the damage that you receive. But that doesn't really matter. The more important thing is the troops dead. And as you can see here, HP is more effective in doing that. HP reduces the number of dead troops significantly more in all cases. Okay, but when you have a buff, it doesn't apply to a single layer. It applies to a full army, so the numbers of troops matter too. The basic stats are the same for everyone, but marches and armies can be very different for different players. Now, this is the tool that I made, and the first thing you need to do in this sheet is to enter the number of troops you have in the situation you want to consider. So if it is for defense, this will be your total troops. But if, for example, it's an archer attack, it would be your archer march preset. You can use my account manager tool to set your presets based on a layering scheme and simply copy and paste from there. The video for that tool should appear up on the screen. Here, I'm considering my ground march. So what you see here is my ground preset. And this is what I want to do. I want to craft a new civilization equipment for my ground general. I can make one, and I'm considering either Antonine leg armor or Antonine helmet. Currently, I have two Ares pieces, and if I switch one, I will lose the two piece set buff, and I have some nice refinements on them that I'm going to lose as well. Some of them are percentages, some of them are flat. So it's not immediately obvious which one to drop. So in the tool, after you enter your troops here, in this sheet, you can see your total troop stats in the base case without any buffs. And here, Vanguard durability and rearguard attack are highlighted, which is particularly important for keep defense. I take the total of HP and defense as a measure of durability, and this is the sum of the two. This is the total row, which sums up all the values, and this is the grand total of everything. Obviously, for ground march, almost all of the stats are coming from ground, and especially ground HP and defense. Then you enter your buffs here. Percentages, flat buffs, and then the enemy debuffs. This is the share of your buffs that you expect that the enemy is going to cancel out with their debuffs. Here I assume my opponent is much bigger, so it is going to max out on all of the debuffs, so all are 50%. Now here you see your stats after all of these buffs are applied. And below you can see the actual increase resulting from those buffs. So I'm now only including all my current equipment buffs, set buffs and refines, simply because I'm making a comparison and everything else is going to stay the same in all cases. So obviously most of the buffs are applied to ground troops and the rest wouldn't matter anyway because they're just layers. And as you can see here, the majority of this increase is in Vanguard, basically ground durability, HP and defense. Now, if I click save here, then I can get a copy of this sheet. I call this current setup. So I save all of these values and then I can change in the main sheet. I can change the buff values for the other scenario. I already did that. So the buffs, if I replace the leg armor, are here, and those, if I replace the helmet, are here. So as compared to my current setup, down here, if you look at the numbers, if I switch the leg armor, I will gain a bit more attack, but lose a tiny bit of defense and lose a lot of HP. And if I switch the helmet, I gain a little bit of attack, lose even more HP, going to 1-3%, but gain a little bit of defense here. So what I think I will do in this comparison is to go with the leg armor and then get the refines first high enough to compensate this loss in HP and then make the switch. So this was just a simple example to show you how this works, but it can be very useful considering defense buffs. I think this version with this save button would not work on Mac. So I'm including two different versions with and without this macro enabled in the description for you to download. In the next video, I'm going to discuss a little bit about the value of flat buffs and whether they are overrated, underrated, properly rated. So make sure to subscribe, drop a comment, and hit the like button if you like this video. Until next time.